sum of, now we are going to find the way we did for sum of terms or n terms in a GP. Okay, now it's interesting to observe something. Okay, we'll try and observe that once we are done with this analysis. Now, you remember how did we find sum of n terms in an AP? Anyone remember what did we do? You can unmute and say, what did we do then? Remember, yes or no? Reverse and add, right? What should we do here? How should we find out sum of n terms in a GP? Will reversing help? In this case, reversing will not help. Okay, so let's, you know, learn this process of finding reciprocate and add. So you are saying reciprocate and add. So S is equal to, let's say, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 16 plus 32. So you are saying, will 1 by S be equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 16 plus 1 by 32? Do you think this is correct? Right? Will this be helpful? It is not going to help. Anyways, not correct. So what do we do? So learn this process, very, very crucial for all your efforts later on in sequence and series till JE. You need to learn this. What is that? Let's say Sn is equal to A1. N depicts number of, right, terms. So A1, A2, A3, A4, plus, let's say, an minus 1 and an, sum of n terms of a GP. Okay, this is step number 1. Step number 2, can I write the same Sn as a plus ar plus ar squared ar cubed plus, like that, ar n minus 2 and ar n minus 1. Agree? All of you agree to this one? This part? Is the same thing? Yes or no? Is step 2 clear? All clear? A common? No. Is clear? Is that clear to everyone? Now, third step, where the game starts. I am multiplying both sides or the entire equation by common ratio R. Okay, so what will happen? This will become R times Sn. And the first term, what is the first term after multiplying the right hand side? What is the first term? AR. So I'm not writing AR there, I will write AR here. Okay. Then second term is AR squared, so I'll write it here. Third term will be AR cubed, I'll write it here. Plus, here it will be AR n minus 2 plus AR n minus 1 and plus AR n. Agree? Do you agree to this? How did n come? Because here it was r to the power 0, from r to the power 0 to n minus 1. If you multiply by r, it will go from 1 to n, correct? Is that okay? I hope this is clear, that it is going from 0 to n minus 1. If you multiply by r, then it will start going from 1 to n. Clear? Yes. Is this clear? Now what you need to do is, simply, if this was 1 and 2, subtract 1 from 2. So you will get 4th. Sn common and r minus 1. Right? And here, if you subtract, all these terms will get cancelled. 0. 0. What is left? Left only will be a r n minus A. Correct? So fifth, Sn is nothing but A common R to the power n minus 1. Got it? Isn't it? Bolo. All of you agree? So we just got sum of n terms of a GP. Correct? In case of AP, if you recollect, what was in the case of AP? Sum of n terms was nothing but Sn barabar n upon 2 2a plus n minus 1d. Right? Here Sn is a times r to the power n minus 1 by r minus 1. Is this sum clear? How minus? I subtracted 2 minus 1. Right? Is this clear? 2 minus 1. So hence, when you subtract the RHS of second, it will become minus, right? No. Right? So please remember, in GP we learned what all? Nth term An is ARN minus 1, and now Sn is ARN minus 1 divided by R to the power N minus 1 divided by R minus 1. Clear? Bolo. So, in a way, you got something. What is this Sn? Can I write this as A? Correct? So, you got another identity. If you check, this is Sn, and this is how much? A times 1 plus R square plus dot 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 till R n minus 1. Yes or no? This is what we got. Clear? If I cancel A from both sides, what do I get? R n minus 1 n is equal to R minus 1 times 1 plus R square. Do you see something here? Do you see something here? When n is equal to 2, you learned in 9th grade. N is equal to 2, it will be r square minus 1, and this is simply r minus 1, r plus 1, or 1 plus r, correct? 1 to power n would be 1, yes. So I'm just trying to express it like this. Right? So it works for any. The general identity is this. A to the power n minus b to the power n is how much? A minus b. Then a n minus 1 plus a n minus 1 b plus a n minus 2 b square plus dot dot dot. Keep going. A b n minus 2 and finally b n minus 1. This is the identity. Another piece of information for you. Right? In this identity, if you put A is equal to R and B is equal to 1, you will get this. Right? So it's coming from there, isn't it? So hence you can find out the sum of this GP easily. What is the sum of this GP? Rn minus 1 divided by R minus 1. Is this clear? The both way analysis. You got an identity from the sum of a GP. Okay. Always remember, this is a very important identity. And what else do you now see? If A and B are integers, then A to the power n minus B to the power n will always be divisible by A minus B. Interesting, isn't it? 19 to the power 5 minus 17 to the power 5. Oh, it's easy. Let's say 16 to the power 5. 3 divide this. Yes or no? Do you get that? Implications of same thing. implications of all this, right? 3 divides 19 to power n minus 16 to power n, whatever be the value of n, for any value, positive value of, that means n is a natural number, for any value of n. Interesting, right? So you must catch those insights. Correct? Right? Bolo. So you can see 38 to the power 45 minus 19 to the power 45. 19 divides this. Yes or no? 19 divides this. 19 divides this entity. Correct? So without calculation, you can say very clearly. Understood?